Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Smoke Learning channel. In the previous video, we composited a 3D model using 3D camera tracking and a point cloud to accurately composite the model into the 3D environment. Now there are a few more finishing touches that we will cover over the next few videos. Let's start off by creating a shadow for the 3D model. In order to do this, we need a surface to receive the shadow. Select the Action Schematic view and press Option Escape to see the Connect Effects schematic. Click the Effects Node button to see the Connect Effects node bin. Hover over the Connect Effects node bin and press C. Drag out a Color Frame node and place it in the schematic. Now select the Action node and press Ctrl N to add a new media input. Connect the output of the Color Frame node into the first input of the Media Input node. This automatically creates a new image object in Action. Now let's orientate the surface as the ground floor of the shot. Double-click on Action to select it and load its menus. Press Escape to go back to the Action schematic. As in the previous video, drag a connection from the Point Locators node to the axis of the white surface object. The settings in the Point Locator should be set to Plane Transform. This will orientate the surface just like the 3D model. Double-click on the axis of the white surface object. Drop it down in Z position so it sits just underneath the 3D model. Now let's light the scene and cast a shadow. Switch to the Action node bin menu. Double-click on the Light node to add it to the composite. As before, drag a connection from the Point Locators node to the light. To cast the shadow, select the light and ensure you're in the Action bin menu. Hover over the node bin and press S. Double-click on the Shadow Cast node to add it to the light. Now let's reposition the light to match the other shadows in the shot. Double-click on the white image object in the Action schematic. In the Image menu, set the transparency to 75%. This will allow us to see the original shot. Select the light in the schematic. Increase the Z position to move the light up. Now adjust the X and Y position of the light until you are satisfied with the shadow being created on the white surface. Select the surface again and set its transparency back to 0. Now let's soften the shadow properties. Double-click on the Shadow Cast node. Increase the transparency to about 30%. Next, increase the softness to soften the shadow edge. And increase the color bleed slider for added effect in the darker parts of the shadow. The final adjustment I'd like to make is not to have the camera silhouette cast a shadow on the yellow parts of the 3D model. In the Action schematic, double-click on the Pick with Text Geom. In the Geometry menu, disable shadows altogether. So that looks pretty good. Unfortunately, the original shot is also an image object that is shaded by the light. So we'll have to hide this object and input the same image as the background input, which is unaffected by any shading in Action. Select the image object connected down from the camera 3D node. Press H to hide it. Next, press Option Escape to return to the Connect Effects schematic. Drag an output from the source node into the background input of Action. Select the Action node and press Escape to go back to the Action schematic. The original shot is still the same, but being the background, it is now unaffected by light. So we have the shadow of the 3D model being cast onto the white surface. However, if you hide the white surface, you will lose the shadow. So the workflow is to create separate render passes from Action and recombine them later. This is a similar workflow to other 3D applications that generate render passes. To set up render passes in Action, switch to the Output menu. Currently, Action only has one output. Select the result view. This is the overall composition, or what some refer to as the beauty pass. Select the output and click the Rename button and call this output Beauty. Let's disable what we don't want in the beauty pass. Click the Tools pull-down menu and select Edit Output. This is mapped to Option E on the keyboard. Click the white image object and it grays out. So this will not be rendered in this pass and the shadow will be excluded. This will be recomposed shortly, so we need to create an alpha channel of the 3D model. Select the beauty output in the output list and click Copy. Rename this pass to Alpha. Under the output options, change the output type from Comp to Matte. Finally, let's make a shadow pass. Select the beauty output in the output list and click Copy. Rename this pass to Shadow. Under the output options, change the output type from Comp to Shadow. Now we need to re-enable the white surface. If you're still in Edit Output mode, click on the white surface object. This unhides the surface and the shadow reappears. Select the result view again. So there we have our three render passes ready to be combined together. Let's do this using a comp node. Select the action schematic and press Option Escape to switch to the Connect Effects schematic. Click the Effects Nodes button for the Connect Effects node bin. Drag out a comp node and place it in front of the action node. Now the action node's output is gray, that signifies more than two outputs. Select the action node and press Option C to expand the node outputs. Using this comp node, we'll combine the beauty pass and the shadow pass. Connect the beauty pass into the first red input of the comp node. And drag the shadow output into the second red input of the comp node. Double-click on the comp node for its controls. Set the blend mode to multiply. So the shadow is multiplied back onto the beauty pass minus the white surface. Let's do a bit more work on the 3D model element. Switch back to the Connect Effects node bin. Press B for the blur node. Drag out the blur node and drop it after the comp node. Connect the output of the comp node into the red input of the blur node. Next, connect the alpha output of the action node into the blue matte input of the blur node. Double-click on the blur node for its controls. Set the blur value to 1.0. This should soften the sharpness of the 3D model. If the whole image is affected, enable Use Matte and the blue matte input will constrain the blur to the alpha. Finally, let's do a quick regrain on top of the clean element. Switch back to the Connect Effects node bin. Hover over the node bin and press R for regrain. Drag out the regrain node and connect the front and matte outputs of the blur node into the front and matte input of the regrain node. Double-click on the regrain node for its controls. To sample the grain, hold Ctrl Shift and drag a tiny box selection over a small sample of grain in the image. The regrain controls will show the results of the grain analysis that is added to the 3D model. You can use the same front and matte workflow to add color correction to further blend the elements into the shot. But if you scrub the time bar, you can clearly see that the foreground objects, like the chair, should not be behind the 3D model. Coming soon, we'll finish off our compositing example by cutting out the foreground objects and recomposing them over the 3D element. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.